my voice and keep giving me. I can't find the light if I can't see. And I would rather die than lose my vision. Hey, I should have found someone who isn't me. Be still, my mind. Be still, my mind. With every beat of my heart, let it go. Let it go, dear. Be still, my mind. Let every NBA start. And let it go. Let it all fall apart.
WVKR, WVKR, Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Soren Song's new release titled I'm, and the track Be Still My Heart. If you're regular listeners here, you've heard that one a few times. And Soren, congratulations again on such a beautiful release.
Be Still My Mind.
Be Still My Mind.
It wouldn't be clever if it,
Be Still My Heart.
It has to be clever.
You know, it's like something, it's one of those things, when I get it stuck in my head, I can't unstick it, but you're absolutely right.
When I thought of that name, I went to Google immediately because I was certain it had to be, have been done 1,000 times, and did not see anything that came up, Be Still My Mind. So it was exciting.
Wow.
I'm sure others have thought of it, but nobody
right.
didn't make it to Google, so
right.
it doesn't
right.
count.
It doesn't count. If it's not on Google, it's not there. It did not exist. So, yeah. And thanks again for being here today, Soren Song. As we were talking off air, we have a mutual friend in common, Danny Bloom. And when I had hosted Danny on my show sometime in late summer, I guess you say, he mentioned you. And I always let my artists, my musicians, pick out the music that they're going to play during our conversation. And he chose one of yours. And he's like, Rita, you've got to like find out about Soren Song because they're amazing, really talented, and brilliant songwriter. So here we are months later, and
here we are.
And yeah, thanks so much for being here.
Well,
so it was like,
me,
yeah,
sure.
absolutely. It's my pleasure, my honor. I always like to start out with the beginning of when music came into your world and a little bit about when you first, I mean, everybody hears music. We're in the car as youngsters, you hear it, you what, but when did it first like strike you? What happened when?
There were a few different moments. I grew up, my father was a minister, a long line of evangelical ministers. Same with my mother on her side of the family. All the men were ministers. So I grew up mostly like old hymns.
Mm-hmm.
And then where I grew up, the neighborhood, it was all hip hop and R&B, mostly hip hop that I grew up on. That I wasn't allowed to listen to, but that's when I was with my friends. So really, I grew up on hip hop and old hymns.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know
nothing
the Beatles,
in
no Zeppelin until college. Like I heard those things for the first time.
Wow.
And wow. the end of my senior year, I heard A Day in the Life in a car
senior
with someone.
Senior year of college.
Of high school.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I had been forced to transfer to a little private school from the public school and was driving with a new friend, and this song came on, and I didn't know it was the Beatles. I knew nothing about. It was one of those moments like, this is what music should sound like. This is what I want to sound like. This is what I want to do. And I was like, who is this? He's like, seriously? That's the Beatles. And that started the whole thing for
wow.
me. Yeah.
Wow. Your first instrument, piano?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How old were you there?
I was a late bloomer. I did hip hop for years, mm-hmm. all the way through the end of high school.
When you say did hip hop,
I was a rapper.
You were a rapper?
I started out as a rapper, yes.
Writing your own material?
Writing my own material since I was probably 10 or 11.
Some of your influences from rap?
Hip hop, at that time, I was a big, I think, Mos Def, Nas. I like Naughty by Nature a lot, and Smith and Wesson, Black Moon, all that like kind of early to mid '90s hip hop era. That was that's what I came up on.
Yeah, yeah. And then piano, what were you playing on there?
That was after I heard the Beatles. I was like, oh, maybe I'll try to write songs and sing, because I wasn't a singer. I didn't think I could sing.
Really?
I'd never sang, and I didn't have any reason to believe I could. But I really wanted to. Someone showed me the chords to Let It Be. And they showed me what to do with my left hand, what to do with my right hand, how to find the chords. And I wrote my first song that night, and just, that was it. That was what I did from then on.
Wow. Do you still play your first song?
No, I don't.
No.
No.
Wow.
But I've reconnected with my high school friend who taught me. And, had to thank them for that.
It's sometimes like being in the right place just that moment can just change your trajectory.
It made sense. I could always pick out melodies on the piano mm-hmm. growing up, mm-hmm. but when I learned how to find the chords and what to do with the left hand, then that was when that changed everything for me.
So during high school, you were just really into the hip hop or.
Mm-hmm. All the way till the end, midway through my senior year is when that happened.
And then after high school, college?
Yeah.
And did you?
I went to college as a musician. That was how quickly the turnaround was. Within a few months, that was my
identity. And a pianist.
And a pianist. And yeah. Although my first band, I didn't want to play. I wasn't good enough. I mean, and I didn't want to sing. I didn't know what I was going to do. I just wrote songs. I met a guitarist, and he said, well, we got to get a piano player, and we got to get a singer. And then he tricked me. The first show we booked, he said, well, just sing for this show. And then he just kept not getting a singer until I was a singer. So,
did he know that you actually had a good voice?
Yeah, I'd showed him all the songs and everything.
Right.
But I didn't want to sing in front of people. I never had that. Like some people, I've played in bands with people who are just born showmen. Born, uh-huh. You know, they want to be... No thanks.
You're more in like be in the background.
Yeah, I don't need to be in front
thing.
Of people. Uh-huh. When I started writing songs, I really wanted to play them.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't want, I would be in a room with a piano and be like, man, I wish everybody would just leave so that I could sit and play songs.
And do what you want to do.
Yeah, but the fear of not performing my songs got to be a little bit bigger than the fear of performing them,
uh-huh.
I think. And then, uh-huh. yeah, so it's kind of started happening.
Yeah. So what were like some of the first band names that you were? And I love I was, this part.
My first band and many bands. When I have a band, it's often Jameson Steinway was the name of my very first band.
Uh-huh.
And then I've had four or five incarnations of that band over the years.
Gotcha. We were talking of Nels Klein too, and mm-hmm. he said his first band name. I can't think of it right now, but like him and his brother, his twin brother.
Oh yeah, yeah,
yeah. In L.A. when they were growing up, and I forgot their name.
I think
but
he told me I've heard of that.
Just
yeah.
something like super unique, and I always love like what was the first band name? That
well, most
you had?
As a joke between. I think everybody's first band name has a clever misspelling
mm-hmm.
of a word. Like the Beatles, they started that maybe, but everybody's first band, there's a joke that, you know, there's some sort of a little clever misspelling or something going on.
Right. So you go to college
mm-hmm.
and you start like hearing all this other music.
Yeah. Yeah. That was it. I mean, it was immediate.
Did you think like did you go to college for music?
No, I went to be a minister.
Oh.
Yeah, and then decided
'cause you thought you had to be.
Yeah, but I'd started writing songs and I started a band and then I was very quickly found out I wanted to be the opposite of a minister. That took not even the whole freshman year to figure that one out.
I was going to say, this semester?
Music thing is way better, and I don't have to tell anybody what to think. I just, you know, I sing, and they can take it however they want. And then, that was the time. It was very pivotal because that was when I started deconstructing the mythology I'd been, you know, given as a kid.
Your whole life up until then.
Oh, yeah, it was deep, deep. I mean, this is like my whole world. It's all I knew. Even the college was a small evangelical college. I was going to be a minister. And then I went, it was in Nyack, New York, and I used to walk into town, and I met people. I went to a coffee shop, and there was all these people who, they were just talking about things, and they didn't have the answers. They were just wondering.
They're having conversations.
Yeah, that's what it turns out. That's what it is. And I had never, you know, everybody always had, we knew the answers to everything ahead of time, and then we had to filter everything through that, you know. So it was like the ugly duckling. Like, I walked in and I was like, oh, these are people like me who don't know the answers to everything. And
don't claim to have the answers to everything.
And then, then they tried to cast demons out of me at the school, and that was the last day for me. That's when I walked right out and never
went
back. Yeah. So
good for you. You found your way.
Eventually. Yeah,
eventually. Well, you know, that's okay.
I hope so. I'm still fine. I don't know if there's a way.
Aren't we all finding it, though? Don't we all? Like, seriously? It's like
we're all
the
whole thing.
Killing
time till, you know, the thing we don't talk about.
Right. It's all just a journey. Yeah. It's all whatever it is.
I was also a philosophy major, so that was where my mind was heading.
After you walked out of there, what did you do?
Then it was rough because I had pulled the whole foundation out from under me, and I didn't have anything. I didn't have another foundation to take its place. So it was rough. Like, I left school. I was homeless. Became alcoholic, addict, undiagnosed mental illness. So it was a lot of really hard years. But I kept making music.
Did you?
It was hard.
You kept writing music?
I kept writing music. It was really hard to have any sort of a career because it was such a volatile life, and I never knew where I'd be, So I'd go somewhere, I'd start a band, and it would all kind of fall apart, and I'd move somewhere else. I think I was, most places, I was averaging maybe 4 months living in a place and then hitchhike somewhere else and be there for a while.
What got you
through?
It was
exhausting.
Of course, that is a very
But it was exciting. I mean, when you're
What got there, you out of your addiction and your...
Well, drugs. Mm-hmm. No, it was, I started to, it was, that's kind of part of it. I started doing plant medicine work with people, with, trained professionals in very specific settings of, these ceremonial kind of things.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
I was very opposed to it at first because I didn't want to fall for any spiritual garbage.
Right.
Because
you
I
left
was
that
really,
back
really,
there.
But, it just kind of like called, I felt like it was kind of calling to me. I had friends that kind of had this circle. This kind of spiritual community, and eventually I went over to the dark side there, according to my family, and that broke something in me open. And within that year, I think I went to Peru to work one on one with this healer there, and started to kind of reimagine what music might be, and maybe, other than just singing about unrequited love and, if there could be kind of a deeper, it was almost reconnecting that. So, I started out writing things that were more Christian, and then it was reconnecting to a spirituality without all of the, dogma and stigma all the garbage I didn't like.
Spirituality without the religion.
Yeah. And then again, not having to tell people what to think, but just conveying artistically kind of what was happening to me.
Yeah.
And there's certain things that just really resonate with people, where for me it could be such a specific thing I'm I'm recalling in a song of like that happened to me, and then there's kind of this universal thing where people will have a whole different story but relate and connect really deeply with something. Which, you know, it's such a mystical process, songwriting. Yeah. It's, I still don't know how it works.
Right. But it works because...
Sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes you've got 10 tracks on this newest release of yours.
Yeah, and this is the third one I've done with Danny.
So wonderful. So you come back from Peru.
Uh-huh.
You're a different person. And how did you find... When was that? Like a while, obviously.
That was, that's going back 2011. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
It's going back.
Well, congratulations on your rebirth.
Oh, thank you so much.
And who you are today. So that's a beautiful thing. It's all a journey, you know?
It really is
all a journey. How, your first session, do you remember it? Like what year and who you were with and all of that? Or?
No.
Yeah.
You mean recording?
Yeah, your first recording.
With my band in college, we did, and it was in the radio station.
Uh-huh.
It looked, kind of like this, a similar room. And we were doing it was on to VHS tape, I think.
Wow, yeah,
And it was, everything. It's wild how much has changed since I started, you know, stapling flyers onto, you know, the streetlights or under the telephone poles and whatever. And now, you know, it's just social media
and everything like that.
So,
yeah, it must have been strange because we're sitting at Vassar College here, coming back into a college situation here because we still have some of those billboards, you know,
like
those things here. And this kind of brings us back to our youth, even if we don't want to go there because we're sitting in college.
Yeah, it did feel like, it felt very much like walking back into, just being on a campus. Like, you don't go on campuses
no.
if you don't have a reason to.
No,
I hadn't even thought about it. Unless
you have a child or something.
I played on a campus in quite a while, but like just driving in, it was like, oh, this is such a different world. And I used to know it a long,
long, long.
I still feel college age. And then I see college kids and it's like, oh, they look, seven.
Yeah, they're like little babies.
They're just little children.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. No, I know. There's really...
We weren't.
No reason.
We were old and mature. And...
Well, here you are years later, and we bring you back to college. But thank you for being here, because it is really cool. How'd you find the Hudson Valley?
Through college. I mean, NIAC. It was NIAC College. I was in Syracuse. I went to high school. And... came down, even the first time I came to visit, I just fell in love with NIAC, with the town.
Mm-hmm.
The pizza, I just keep coming back there. And then...
the coffee shop.
Yeah, everything.
Yeah, yeah.
And I moved all over the country and was all over the place, and then I ended up, and I was in the city for quite a while, and then ended up not planning to move back to NIAC, just ended up homeless and losing kind of everything. Probably 15, 16 years ago. And I ran into a friend of mine. He's like, I'm going over to Rockland for the day. Like, might as well be homeless there. And I went and ran into some kids who had used to come see my band. And they're like, come just stay on our couch and figure things out. And that's been about 15 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Sometimes.
I'm not still on their couch. But
No. But you're still living down there.
I'm still in the area.
Beautiful. And how did you find good old Woodstock and our Danny Blue?
Oh, that's a story. So Danny, I was watching a movie called Nebraska.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen it? And the score was just blowing my mind from the very beginning. The score was blowing my mind. So I went on IMDb and I looked up, you know, who did this score. And I had been in a band that was doing really well, but it was a nightmare. And I walked away from that, and it was, I'd gotten married, just gotten married, I had a successful band, everything was looking good, and then the band folded, I think within a week of being married, she lost her job, and suddenly I was working in the city, managing a building, and realizing this is how your dreams die, you know, this is how it happens.
Yeah.
And I had all these songs from the band that never got recorded that I had written, and I really wanted to make an album. So I'm watching this movie, falling in love with the score. And so I looked it up. It was a guy by the name of Mark Orton. And I guessed his email address.
Get out.
Well, everybody has at their own website.
Right.
I put like three, mark@markorton.org, M. Orton, and Mark Orton at all of those.
Man, oh, man.
And one of them was correct.
Wow.
And I got an email back. I had recorded a bunch of solo live things at this studio on a grand piano with me. And sent him that, and he was really into it. And he said, I can't produce it. I'm in Portland, and if I get a movie, I got to do it, you know. But I got a guy in up in Woodstock by you named Danny Bloom, and I'll make an introduction if you want. And I think I went to 5 or 6 different producers to talk about it. And when I met with Danny, when I talked to him, I said, you know, really what I want is to make, you know, growing up, there were those albums that saved my life. Mm-hmm. I was like, I just want to make one of those. Mm-hmm. And he was just like, hell yeah, let's do that. And I was like, all right, this is my guy.
And so the first
three albums later now,
I was going to say, the first album was what, 2017, 18?
No, probably around there.
Yeah.
It's called Beloved.
And now the third album just released in September, titled I'm. And damn, some of the guest musicians you have on here. Tell us who.
Well, those aren't all. I know that in the bio, those are over the course of the albums.
They're
not all on the new one, but Rachel Yamagata sings on Be Still My Mind. There's another local guy who you should have on if you haven't, Tyler Wood, who on this album, he plays keys, but he played organ and he played keyboard bass.
Uh-huh.
And most of the album is him. But yeah, over the albums, I had Nels on the album, which was, I mean, I have
Nels Klein of Wilco, by the way.
I've been a fan of Nels Klein. I mean, a groupie fan. I love him. I love Wilco, but I love him like as much as I love Wilco. Like,
yeah.
His playing.
Yeah.
So that was like,
what a gentleman. You know, I talked to him.
He's the nicest guy.
He's the nicest guy. You know, there's this camp up in Full Moon Resort, right? And a lot of groups get people there. There's a guitar masters camp up there this summer. I said, Nels, you're going to be part of that. And John Schofield, Kurt Rosenwinkel, a whole bunch of great guitars. He's like, you know, I just don't know if I'm going to be good enough. I'm like, don't you know
so
you're
ridiculous.
Nels Klein?
Yeah.
That's what I said to him. And this was on air, you know? This was all on air.
One of the absolute greatest guitarists that has ever, ever played.
Ever. And just sweetest, humblest guy. Just wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah, I've been fortunate to.
So he came into the studio.
Yeah, since then we've kept in touch, but
he sang high praises of you, that people should be knowing your music.
I agree with Nels on that. I mean, you can't argue with Nels,
right? You can't argue with Nels.
He knows what he's talking about. People should know my music. According to Nels,
right.
It'd be nice.
Yeah.
You know, everything I've done, there's this sense of like, oh, this is the one that's going to put it over the top and really, and that hasn't happened, but, which is a bummer. And I would like to have money and food and everything is nice. But, you know, I have the people I've gotten to work with and the things I get to do, and the shows I get to go to. That's one of the perks.
One of the perks.
Like,
for
I couldn't afford to go see Wilco and have a nice seat.
Right.
But, you know.
Right. Nels hooking you.
Yeah, exactly. So that is a big perk, or going to see Rachel, or going to see, you know.
It helps when you know these great musicians.
Yeah, and who knew? I had no idea the Hudson Valley, especially the Woodstock area. When Danny sent me the roster of potential musicians, I thought he was scamming me.
Uh-huh.
Like, there's no way. I know these people.
Yeah.
And there's no way he's got them. And so I just sent back my wish list, and that's who played on the first album.
It is remarkable. That's what started my show. Like, I 9-10 years ago, I was like, man, we have so many amazing musicians that either live here or come here. Let's do a show. And that's the birth of my show. It's just because it's nonstop. It's nonstop. And it's just, it's amazing the talent that is here.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
The first album, it was Jerry Murata. Have you had on the show?
Oh, yeah, several times. Yeah, yeah. Peter Gabriel, like, Paul McCartney, and of course, Jerry. Dreamland Recording Studio.
Yeah, we
also
did. We did a couple tunes out there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, and John Medeski, another.
That was what sold me when I came up to meet with Danny, and he's like, oh, John Medeski was here tracking yesterday.
Uh-huh. They're like friends.
I was like,
yeah,
they're very good friends. Yeah. And I was like, oh man, like he's the best there. I mean, again, like could be argued the best, right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
And he's like, oh, he would sound great on your album. And I was like, don't mess with me, man. Like, and
I
was like, seriously,
me.
You could, he's like, yeah, sure, we could get him. And that was when I was like, okay, that put it over the top for me.
Man, oh man, beautiful. Your second album released in 2019, also with producer Danny Bloom from Hidden Quarry Studios, by the way, up in Bearsville, titled Boundaries, 2019.
Mm-hmm.
And now the one, and I love that they're all one word.
Well, that was going to be a trilogy, and it still might.
Uh-huh.
Beloved, Boundaries, and then there's another album called Believe.
Ah.
But Believe didn't work out, and then in the meantime, I did I'm as a standalone. It's all conceptual, all of the albums and mm-hmm. the songs are.
Let's play another song.
Sure.
While you're sitting here. We're going to do, tell us, Gravity is for Suckers. Just tell us a minute and then we'll play this.
This one's very different. There's only 3 songs on the album that even have drums. And this is actually a song I wrote years ago and had with a band called the Sons of Daddy that we used to do this tune. And found the old recording. This is us. This is the old, this is from... These are the original tracks from 14 years ago, maybe.
Wow.
And then we got them, did a few new things and mixed it and everything.
All right. It's
very different from the rest of the album, but I enjoy it.
Let's play it. Gravity is for Suckers. We're talking with Soren Song, who's got a show coming up 2 weeks from today, March 6th, at the Pines in Mount Tremper. Let's take a listen to this new track from the album titled I'm. The song, Gravity is for Suckers, here on 91.3 WVKR.
Pin to the bottom of it. You see my phone and all your friends.
91.3 WVKR, independent radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Soren Song. That was fun. Gravity is for suckers. Tell us. It is so different than all the other tracks.
Yeah, very much so.
And this was an original piece from years
ago. This was from when I first moved to Nyack, so probably going 14, 15 years ago I wrote it. And I had a band I used to play with that was more...
What were they called?
They were called... The first one was Jameson Steinway, then the Sons of Daddy. And it was just like ridiculously talented musicians. Mm-hmm. Two big guitars, totally unnecessary, except just it was fun.
Right.
And we played big, fun music. And for me, I got to, you know, have a little more... Go a little more in like the, you know, a little harder, rockier direction for a while. So it was fun.
Fun to mix it up a little bit.
Oh,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, yeah. Talk to me about your songwriting process.
Oh, it's still the same as I just sit down at the piano.
When you, every day? Like
no,
you just sit
down? No, not at all. Like I'm totally undisciplined with that. Uh-huh. Just whenever, mm-hmm. whenever the, you know, and so, usually nothing happens, mm-hmm. but sometimes I just start playing some notes and some chords, and then the melody just kind of starts happening, and I start mumbling sounds, mm-hmm. and they start to eventually turn into words and phrases, totally not doing anything, you know, it just happens, and then those become, like, the lyrics, those become the songs, like, it just happens, it just really is a channeling.
So the melody and the words kind of simultaneously.
Even the words, like, they're just kind of coming out of my mouth and I'm not. And then it's like a puzzle, which I love puzzles. So then it's like the second verse, you just have to figure out what it is you're trying to say and use the same kind of a scheme that you, you know. Like the first verse and the chorus are usually just direct, inspired, channeled, whatever. And then you just fill in the rest and make it, you know, make it a nice song.
Yeah.
And make things rhyme occasionally and, you know, switch words and ideas around so people think you're really deep. And there's all kinds of tricks to sound like you're very deep musically.
But you
I'm not. It's very shallow.
You don't think so?
No, it's just I use the tricks very well.
Uh-huh.
Very good at that. Very good at tricking people into thinking I'm deep.
So the 10 tracks that are on your newest release,
yeah.
Come from, obviously, the track we just heard, Gravity is for Suckers. That came mm-hmm. from decades ago. The other 9 tracks, what was like the... Were they all within 6 months? Was it years?
No,
they're all
different. There's a couple of them that are older. Mm-hmm. I think that one, there's another one that's even older than that. The second track on I Didn't Mean to Be a Stone. And then some of them happened during the album, like Dear Sadness... was well into the album that I wrote that
I on. Wish I could play it. I tell people, where yeah. can people find your music?
Anywhere, any streaming service.
Are you on Bandcamp?
I'm on Bandcamp. If people actually want to spend some actual money, they mm-hmm. can certainly go to Bandcamp.
Yep.
And find me there. But if they do want to hear it, they can do, you know, Spotify or YouTube or
Bandcamp, folks. Let's support local musicians.
I'm with that. Yeah, I used to have a link to Spotify, and the link just said, don't go to Spotify.
Yeah.
That was...
No. I don't even use Spotify in here. Yeah. I host a radio show. People are like, what? I just don't.
It was devastating. My first album, I ate lunch with that album.
Uh-huh.
I'd sell a couple copies, and I'd eat.
Right.
And now...
Now that doesn't happen anymore.
I mean,
yeah.
Cost way more to make an album,
right?
And then
you're not getting anything back.
I'm not making that back at this point.
So Bandcamp is the thing to do. This show is also dedicated to musicians that perform and go out and support live music. At the end of every show here, I do what's called musical happenings, where I just like list stuff, area venues, and just it's so important to support local musicians and the local venues wherever local is to you. I'm not just saying like here, mm-hmm. I'm just saying
for sure.
I think like that's like such an important thing to do, And I just, I mean, we pay for everything. We pay $5 for a stupid cup of coffee nowadays. What is it to go to Bandcamp and actually buy music from an artist? You know, so I strongly just, you know, folks, Bandcamp, just take a look at it and see if you see any artists on there that you like. And it's only a couple bucks, you know. And Soren Song is on there, and he's today's guest. And you can also check out his really cool website, SorenSong.com, and you can learn about the other releases that he has as well. 2 weeks from tonight, tell us what's happening Wednesday, March 6th.
I'm going to be up at a place called The Pines.
Jeremy.
Mount Tremper.
Yes.
This is outside of Woodstock. I played up here. I did my album release at Graveside Variety.
Yeah.
And it went really, really well. And I like playing in that area. It's just a little restaurant that you wouldn't expect live music or much of anything. And
Burnell
I went up,
Pines,
yeah, Danny's been doing the Catskill Harmony Guild or whatever it is.
And he's doing that tonight.
He's doing that tonight. And I'm going, we're going to go up to Woodstock,
nice,
to Mount Tremper. And we're going to listen to some incredible, he gets the best musician.
Yeah.
And I went for the first time last month. And, I've never seen him fronting, leading,
uh-huh,
like being a band leader. I've seen him play along with people, including me, and be a side man. But like watching him do his thing, I was impressed, honestly.
I told him, why does it have to be on a Wednesday? Because I can't leave and go all the way. So I'm just like, oh, I wish you would do it on a different night. Danny Bloom is an incredible gifted guitarist, mm-hmm, as well as producer.
Oh, yeah.
He's, all that
he's
stuff.
He's producer, engineer, mixer, but also has played guitar on a lot of
the
tunes. So it's nice having someone with so many hats.
Yes.
A lot of times it's just me and him in there.
Right. Right. Yeah. Having a lot of fun. That's for sure. Man. So Soren Song up at the Pines in Mount Tremper, Wednesday, March 6th. You can also go to SorenSong.com and Bandcamp. The new release is called I'm. It was released back in September. Yes. September.
Yes.
And, and support local music, folks, and Bandcamp and all of that. What else would you like to get out there?
I actually do have one kind of exciting thing.
Tell us.
I've got a new project with my friend Travis Stever. He's in a band called Coheed and Cambria.
Uh-huh.
And then he's got a super group with a bunch of folks from those kind of bands called LS Dunes right now that's been taking off. And he was my neighbor, happened to move in across the street from me. And we hit it off and started working on some stuff this, 6 years ago. And we just got back to it and got in the studio. So that'll be coming out. I'm not sure what the name of the project is, but we've got four songs. It's the collaboration between him and I. It's very different than what I do, very different than what he does. And we found kind of this new area to
this
explore
in between
musically.
For the both of you.
Kind of, it's still got a little bit of that folky Americana, but it's a little more, maybe some up-tempo. And more.
Can you send me like a link when you get
sure,
it?
Yeah,
I'd love to play it.
We have one song that's actually finished that I'll send to you.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, so I'm excited about that.
I love playing new music and just like listening to new stuff. And this album, congratulations on it.
Thank you so much.
It really is a beautiful 10-track album. We're going to play us and we're going to play another track or two after that. And I appreciate you being here today in person.
You having me. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And thank you, SorenSong.com. Go see him in person if you're up in the Woodstock, Ulster County area, March 6th, 2 weeks from tonight at the Pines. Beautiful, intimate little place. Great libations, some great food up there, and better yet, some great music with Soren Song on March 6th and SorenSong.com. Check out the release titled I'm. We've heard a couple of tracks from it here now. We're going to listen to the track called Us. Tell us about this track before we bid you farewell.
Sure. This one actually has a little bit of a story. It was written as a duet, and I spent almost the entirety of the 2 years while we were making this album trying to find who to sing it with.
Wow.
And tried a few people, and it just wasn't quite the right fit. And I ended up doing it all myself, which it was a kind of a metaphor for my queer non-binary journey. So that was kind of going to be, you know, the inside scoop of the tune anyways. But then I decided, hey, if, you know, if I'm non-binary and these are representing both of the poles in myself, maybe I'll just try singing my own solo duet.
And
so that's what it is.
And that's exactly the way it was supposed to happen for you.
I think so. Yeah,
yeah, and you didn't find somebody because it was all meant to be you the whole time.
Yep.
So, all right, let's take a listen to Us. Again, this is Soren Song. The album is titled I'm. You can check them out on Bandcamp. Also, the website, SorenSong.com. And better yet, go see him live 2 weeks from tonight at the Pines in Mount Tremper. Thank you again for your time and for coming here in person. And it's a little detour. Now you can head on up north.
Head on up and listen to some great music at the Pines tonight.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Thank you. All right, let's take a listen to Us here on 91.3. WVKR, Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York.
Love, is this only a fable? Patterned on lines in the sand. No cards on the table. Destiny, sleight of hand. And do we give it a label, or do we choose to understand that we don't understand? I'm here, I'm able. My woman, I'll be your man. Love, I'm a woman of action. Dive right in and then decide. Us, is this only a fraction of what's to come? What's to divide? And do we choose a reaction, or do we choose to understand that we don't understand? I demand satisfaction. I'll be your woman, be my man. Lightning rod, oh my God, I'm exposed. Your kind regard, it's not so hard just to know. Lights are flashing lights, camera in action. It's a long way down. How did I get here into your atmosphere? How did I get down? I know I don't wanna die, but Jesus Christ,
When the World Gave Way by today's guest, Soren Song, from the album called I'm. We also heard the track Us, same album, I'm. You can find it on Bandcamp or wherever you get your music, but preferably Bandcamp because you're actually supporting a musician when you do that. SorenSong.com. For more info about today's guest. Also, if you missed part of that interview or just logging on now, we'll be uploading it tonight on the YouTube channel as well as the Facebook page under Local Motion on 91.3 WVKR. It's always much appreciated if you would follow and subscribe to both of those. Thank you. I'm your host, Rita Ryan, here each and every Wednesday from 4 to 6 p.m., bringing you music of the Hudson Valley. We're going to do one more track from Soren Song's release, and then we are going to switch it over to another hour of some great local music. Let's take a listen to this track called Man the Wheel, 91.3 WVKR.
Man, the wheel of my head, right over my head.
91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Man the Wheel by Soren Song from the release titled I'm, which was released back in September 2023. My guest today, thank you, Soren Song, for being my guest here today. You can visit sorensong.com. Check out his music on Bandcamp. It's really beautifully done. Also recorded right in Woodstock. Actually, I think it's Bearsville at Hidden Quarry Studio with Danny Bloom at the helm. Master producer, mixer, and musician himself. Does a great job. Danny Bloom, Hidden Quarry Studio. It is 5 p.m. and you are tuned into beautiful campus here. We're broadcasting live at Vassar College, 91.3 WVKR. You are tuned into Local Motion here each and every Wednesday from 4 to 6 p.m. bringing you music of the Hudson Valley. If this is your first time tuning in, this show is all about music from the area. So we talk to musicians that live here and those coming to record in our world-class area recording studios. So that's what this show's all about. And again, please give a like and a follow on Facebook and on YouTube under 91.3 WVKR. What we're going to do now is play some music, and I'm looking for the track, and I know I had it, but I certainly don't know what I did with it. Okay, we're going to go backwards. Typically, I always start off each and every hour where I don't have a guest with a track from Tony Falco's playlist in order to honor him. And I don't seem to have the link here. So what I'm going to do is go backwards, and I'm going to start it off with the second song instead of the first song. But anyway, this is by Alexis P. Suter, and what we're going to do is listen to her and then play a track from Tony Falco's playlist. So not going to want to miss this. And in the meantime, let's take a listen to Alexis P. Suter here on 91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York.
Come on, yeah. I will never leave you. Only love. protection. They'll see every man's fall. I swear I see my reflection. Some will so have above walls. I see my life for shining. God dwells under me. Let me dare love and
WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. The voice is one of the most recognizable vocals I know of, Joe Cocker, the track called I Shall Be Released from his album With a Little Help from My Friends, originally, of course, written by Bob Dylan in 1967, but he was not the first one to record it. The English singer Boz recorded it in May of 1968, and then the band released it in July 1968 on their debut album, From Big Pink. Dylan finally released it on his greatest hits, volume something or other. I forgot which one, but that's where that came from. But what a beautiful rendition that we just heard from Joe Cocker, because it was also on Tony Falco's playlist. So what we do is we start off every hour on the show that we don't have a guest by playing a track from Tony Falco to honor him, to commemorate him, to thank him for everything that he did for music in the Hudson Valley. Tony passed away October 27th of 2021. And he left many things, one of them being this incredible playlist. And I go down in order of when he uploaded it. So I don't know what's playing next week. And I just kind of go in order. And this was the song this week. We also got it started today with Alexis P. Suter, her album called Be Love. And we heard this title track from that album that was released back in 2019. Alexis P. Suter. .com. She is going to be doing a show at the Beautiful Falcon this Saturday night, and it's titled To Tony with Love. So it's Alexis P. Suter's birthday, and it's a show dedicated to Tony Falco. The band's going to be playing songs from Tony's playlist. Alexis P. Suter is a 3-time Blues Music Award nominee, and she has one hell of a band. There are six people in the band, and just you walk out, you feel like you've gone to church once you've seen her. I unfortunately have to miss this show, and I'm really disheartened about it. It usually sells out. It's a great night out. Again, this Saturday night at the Falcon in Marlboro. You can check out, make reservations at liveatthefalcon.com. Alexis P. Suter Band there this Saturday night. And let's see, where are we? It's 5:13. I'm your host, Rita Ryan, here each and every Wednesday from 4 to 6 p.m. And last week's guest was Rachel Z and her husband, Omar Hakim. They're going to be playing Sunday at the Town Crier in Beacon with a group called Sonic Boom Band, headed by Omar Hakim, the jazz legend. Let's take a listen to some music of Omar Hakim here on 91.3 WVKR. This is called Rhythm Deep, is the album. Crucial to Groove is the track.
To do. It's crucial to groove.
yeah. 91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Ian Hendrickson-Smith has got one heck of a party happening at Uncle Chief, the club that he owns, tonight through Saturday. He's playing every night and celebrating his big birthday, which is his 50th birthday. Ian Hendrickson-Smith is the saxophonist for Jimmy Fallon's The Tonight Show, was also a guest here on Local Motion, and owns the club, the jazz club in Brewster, called Uncle Chief, UncleChief.com. Again, tonight through Saturday, you can see Ian Hendrickson-Smith's 50th birthday bash he's going to be celebrating. We just heard the track called Mamacita from the album Party of Three. We also heard Omar Hakim, the album called Crucial to Groove, and we heard the track Rhythm Deep. He'll be performing with his group called Sonic Boom Band, which includes last week's guest, his wife, Rachel Z, and a few others. He'll be performing this Sunday in Beacon at the Town Crier Cafe. Tickets and info available at towncrier.com, and that's town spelled with an E, crier.com. Let us now play some music by Cindy Cash Dollar here on 91.3 WVKR. Let's take a listen to the title track from Waltz for Abilene, 91.3. 91.3 WVKR, Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. It's 5:31. It is Wednesday, and we just heard Tombs Dixon. They are so much fun. They've played around a couple of times. We recently hosted Rich Pagano, who's the drummer, and also Jack Petroselli, the guitarist, both of whom are going to be playing at the Local in Saugerties for a sold-out show happening this Saturday night. Another show that I'm missing because I'm going to be out of town. So Saugerties Sessions happening this weekend with Tombs Dixon and Cindy Cashdollar, who we also heard prior to them. Cindy Cashdollar's latest release called Waltz for Abilene. We heard the title track featuring Larry Campbell. The one and only Larry Campbell is on fiddle and mandolin. And we do have to say a huge happy birthday shout out to Maestro Larry Campbell. Today, Larry celebrates his birthday. I'm also going to be playing in a few tracks the new release that just came out by Larry and Teresa, like I think yesterday. So stay tuned for that. But a huge happy birthday to Larry Campbell. Let's take a listen now to Mr. Eric Squindo, who's going to be presenting a show at Colony in Woodstock on March 3rd that I'll tell you more about. But first, let's take a listen to a track called Damn the Soothsayer here on 91.3.
My burdens and I'll trade them for a dream. Come sharing my trouble, got more than I need. It's hard to keep waiting when that weight's put on. Damn the soothsayer, he got it all wrong. I can still hear her say, don't you worry, my son, I'm not going away. I'll be there when you're lonesome, looking for a song. Damn the soothsayer, I'll never be gone.
91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. That is the Christine Spiro Group. Spiro plays Nero, the music of Laura Nero. We heard The Picnic, consisting of Christine Spiro, Elliot Spiro, Scott Petito on bass guitars, and Peter O'Brien on drums. The Christine Spiro Group will be performing Spiro Plays Nero this Sunday at the Town Crier in Beacon, New York. Tickets available at towncrier.com. And that's town with an E, crier.com, to see this Sunday the Christine Spiro Group playing the music of legendary Laura Nero. We also heard Eric Squindo, the album called Damn the Soothsayer, Back on the Scene. The track was Damn the Soothsayer. The album is called Back on the Scene. It's an EP that was released in 2021, and vocals there is also featuring Amy Labor on banjo. She's also on backing vocals, Andrew Schober on bass, and Manuel Quintana on percussion. And of course, heading it all up, Eric Squindo on acoustic guitar and vocals, and also the songwriter of that. So Eric Squindo has presented numerous shows and is doing just that again on Sunday, March 3rd. It's called Be Here to Love Me, The Songs of Towns Van Zandt. This is happening at Colony in Woodstock. And the show also marks the 5th anniversary of ESP Productions, Eric Squindo Productions. So he has been paying homage to numerous different artists such as John Prine or Tom Waits, Dolly Parton. He's performed with many, many musicians. It's going to be an all-star cast that Sunday evening. It's a week from Sunday, March 3rd, featuring, of course, Eric Squindo, Kenny Roby, Amy Labor, Mark Delgado, Kyle Esposito, Kate Brasher, Matt White, Mr. Roper, John Light, even my daughter, Caroline Ryan, will be on fiddles. So it's going to be one heck of a fun night, and it's all in honor of the Songs of Towns Van Zandt. Again, that's happening Sunday, March 3rd at Colony in Woodstock. Tickets available at colonywoodstock.com. Eric Squindo presents. And let's see, where are we? 5:40. Let's play the birthday boy a song, and then we'll come out and we'll do musical happenings. As mentioned earlier, today is the birthday of the incredible, the formidable, the unsurpassed talent of Larry Campbell. And today we celebrate his birthday. Larry and Teresa are releasing a new album in April and have released two singles. The first one we've already played here, Desert Island Dreams. And this one, I believe, was just released yesterday. And this is called The Way You Make Me Feel. Happy birthday, Larry. And let's take a listen to their newest single just released, The Way You Make Me Feel, right here, right now on 91.3.
There's a bright sun somewhere. There's a bright sun somewhere. Let's not rest until we find it. There's a bright sun somewhere. There's more joy somewhere. There's more joy somewhere. Let's not rest until we find it. There's more joy somewhere. And there's more peace somewhere. peace somewhere. Let's not rest until we find it. There's more peace somewhere. There's more love somewhere. Let's not rest until we find it. There's more love somewhere.
Somewhere. 91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Happy Traum, the legendary folk artist Happy Traum, from his album There's a Bright Side Somewhere. We heard the title track of that. Happy Traum, truly a legend. Lucky to have him here in the Hudson Valley. He lives in Woodstock. And the first time that Bob Dylan recorded Blowin' in the Wind, Happy Traum was in the studio with him. So Happy truly is a legend. HappyTraum.com. He's also the owner of Homespun Tapes. And if you're not familiar with him, he really is iconic. And grew up in the 50s in the Greenwich Village heydays, just as the folk scene was happening, and has worked with countless musicians, Bob Dylan included. And then we heard The Birthday Boy and his beautiful bride, Larry Campbell, Teresa Williams. Their new album is being released in April, and we heard the track that was just released yesterday, The Way You Make Me Feel, by Larry Campbell and Teresa Williams. They will be guests again here on the show. Let me tell you when. In April, April 10th, Larry and Teresa will be guests here. They were our first ever guests on the show here many moons ago, like 8 or 9 years ago, and they come back at least once a year, and it's going to be so much fun. So April 10th, stay tuned for Larry Campbell and Teresa Williams. What we do now towards the end of the show, because that's where we're getting near, is we do what's called musical happenings. We list venues in alphabetical order in the hopes that you go out and support the music and the musicians and our beautiful area venues. Let's start off with the Bardavon and UPAC, bardavon.org. February 23rd, Trombone Shorty. February 27th, Bianca Del Rio Dead Inside Comedy Tour. Bearsville Theater in Woodstock, also at bearsvilletheater.com. March 30, Masters of the Telecaster. Uncle Chief in Brewster, also at unclechief.com. Tonight through Saturday, Ian Hendrickson Smith's 50th birthday bash. Sunday, Brazilian Jazz Brunch with Tyler Blanton. City Winery, Hudson Valley in Montgomery. Also info at citywinery.com. February 24th, School of Rock, Beacon Winter Music Festival. March 4th, David Nail. March 10th, Will Hope. Colony in Woodstock and colonywoodstock.com. Tonight, the Bobcats. Thursday, Lady Smith Black Mambozo. Friday, Evan Honer with Jesse Woods. Saturday, Dead Man's Waltz. Sunday, Hudson Valley Flyers. And every Monday is an open mic at Colony. At the Falcon in Marlboro. And live at thefalcon.com. Friday, Muscle Shoals tribute to the Allman Brothers. Saturday, Alexis P. Suter to Tony with Love. And Sunday, Spiro plays Nero. I just realized that I said that that show was at Town Crier. It is not at Town Crier. I just played a track by Spiro Plays Nero. The show that they're playing is actually at the Falcon this Sunday. Spiro Plays Nero. Howland Chamber Music Circle at Howland Cultural Center in Beacon. Info and tickets at howlandmusic.org. March 3, Ying Lee. Jazz Forum in Tarrytown. Info at jazzforumarts.org. This Friday and Saturday, two shows each night featuring Christian Sands Quartet. The Local in Saugerties. Also, thelocalsaugerties.com. February 24th, Saugerties Session with Cindy Cashdollar and Tombs Dixon. March 2nd, African American Folk, Blues, and Dixieland Jazz with Jaron Paxton and Dennis Lichtman. The Stissing Center in Pine Plains, also at thestissingcenter.org. March 2nd, The Goonies. March 8th, The Slocan Ramblers. Tarrytown Music Hall in Tarrytown, also at tarrytownmusichall.org. February 22nd, Justin Williams. February 24, Aztec Two-Step. March 2nd, Wanda Sykes. Town Crier in Beacon and towncrier.com. Every Thursday is an open mic. Friday, Mark Von M. on the Salon Stage, and on the main stage, Mary Fall, formerly of October Project. Saturday, Frank Veeley on the Salon Stage, and on the main stage, The Weaklings, Music of the Beatles and More. Sunday Brunch with Margie Zintz, and Sunday Evening, Omar Hakim and Sonic Boom Squad at Town Crier. Folks, that's what I got this week. It is 5:53. Dr. J's in the house, so stay tuned for Irie Groove coming up at the top of the hour. I will not be here next week. I will be back in 2 weeks, and my guest will be Danny Melnick, who is the co-owner of The Local in Saugerties and also producer of the Saratoga Jazz Festival. So we're going to be talking all things Saratoga Jazz Fest in 2 weeks with Danny Melnick. And in 3 weeks, oh, be still my heart, Jorma Kaukonen will be my guest. Looking forward to that. I always do. It's always such an honor. And a huge honor for having today's guest on the show, Soren Song. Thank you for your time on the show today. The new release called I'm. You can find him on Bandcamp or on his website, on their website at sorensong.com. I'm going to play another track or two of that, and then we'll hand the airwaves over. Let's see. Right now, we're going to play the track called Believe from today's guest, Soren Song, here on 91.3. WVKR.
Still can't breathe when you walk in the room. When did I become lost to you? Little birds, they fly, and I can't get the best of them. But one day I'll try, and I'll fly like the rest of them. I still can't believe that you could not believe. Lightning strikes when you walk in the room. Scared and in love with you. Little birds, they fly.